CP Fox.
What?
CP Fox.
Oh, there he goes.
Thank you.
Thank you.
This is not House on the Rock. Peggy. Peggy. I like trains.
Using this hand crank on the side, they can raise the tableau up to its over 20-foot height, and that's how they would have pulled it on the parade route. Once they were done with that, they can lower it back down completely into this first layer of tableau. Are the original iron parts from the 1850s to 1860s. So they still work even to this day. Last time we pulled this guy out was 2006 for our Great Milwaukee Circus Parade. We're going to start with this giant golden shoe. This is one of seven pony floats that were made for the P.T. Barnum and Greater London Circuses back in 1882. Of the seven, only three still exist today. We do have all three of them right here at Circus World. And all three of them are covered in 24-karat gold leaf.
The three that we have are all based on fairy tales. So we do have the old lady who lived in the shoe here. We have Mother Goose in the corner by the window over there. And then not in this room, but in the main field building on your way out is Cinderella. To give you an idea of what goes into one of these guys, this guy is made up of 2x4s stacked up on top of each other and then carved in the shape of a shoe. So for restoration purposes, every single layer had to come off, be re-sanded down, put back together in order, and then finally we could start working on all the little children. If we could save the children, we just basically did the same thing we do with any other piece of tableau. We just recarved any of the detail into the faces. Otherwise, if we could not save it, we had to re-hand carve from scratch. So as we walk down, we're going to talk a little bit about these Wild West Road here on the left. Sawyer with Pawnee Bill Wild West Wagon. This guy was built in 1903 for a cost of $4,000. Nowadays, that would be about $125,000 with inflation. But it is absolutely worth it. It is known as the best hand-carved wagon of all time. It features two completely different tableaus. You have Christopher Columbus discovering America on the left here, on my left, towards you guys. And on the other side, you have Pocahontas saving John Smith from the Braves. Which, it's interesting that they're so well hand-carved because first and foremost, this was a transportation wagon. So it would have been out in all the elements all year round, and also being offloaded and reloaded almost every day, at least twice a day. So as we walk down, we have two props that were used in Wild West shows. We have the chuck wagon from the 101 Wild West show that was featured in an attack on a caravan where they would circle about five of those up and then set fire to the canvases. That was about five shows a week. So unfortunately, because of the fire damage, basically anything from the hip up is completely new, but all the iron pieces on the undercarriage are actually the originals from the late 1800s. So it's cool to have that back here. And then we do have our chuck wagon, or not chuck wagon, geez Louise, our stagecoach. This was an actual stagecoach used to deliver mail before it was purchased by the Buffalo Bill Wild West Show. When they purchased it, they turned it into a prop where they would have about four of these guys go in a circle. They would have bandits come and try and rob the stagecoach, only for the U.S. cavalry to come over, jump onto the caravans, and save the day. When Buffalo Bill came back from their European tour, they found that the United States had moved down from the Wild West Show. So as they traveled from east to west, they started losing a lot of money. But to help keep their show afloat, they would barter away wagons like this one to help pay or do a trade for oats for animals to keep them fed, or actual pay to keep the performers there. The gold one on your right is the very first hand wagon used by the Wrigley brothers, and it was our very first attempt at 24-karat gold leafing. As it stands today, it is now worth over $80,000 worth of gold leafing. But again, it is absolutely worth it, especially on parade day when we get it outside, the band's on there playing their hearts out. It just looks and sounds absolutely incredible. Walt Disney in 1962 donated six wagons to us to help us with our collection here at Circus World. Little did we know that that would actually give us our first case of national recognition. Our Gadbilly Band room here was built in 1905 in Paris, France by the Gadbilly Band Company. They built it for a traveling circus right here in the United States. Unfortunately, that circus went out of business after a couple of years. And when they did, they took everything they still owned, including this band organ, put it in a barn in Kansas where it remained untouched for 35 years. Luckily, it was found, purchased, and eventually made its way to right here at Circus World, where it underwent a 25-month renovation process. But I will let you know that once it gets playing, it is very, very loud. It does produce the sound of an 80-piece orchestra, and it's directed right at you in the middle cage. Thank you.
Keep off the wagon. Stay off the wagon.
In more ways than one.
Yeah, no kidding. Gotta get to the tigers. Asia. I know, this is awesome. Mm-hmm. Wow. It is, wow. Yeah, it is.
Oh gosh.
If you may.
There you go. Beautiful.
Fabulous.
I'm going to have to go over somewhere over there for the tigers. Hey, I want to get on a cart.
I know, really.
Hey, how do you rate? Oh, look at, they got kids in there.
Yeah, I told you.
What?
I don't remember. I'm not Circus World. You guys were in a cage.
Okay, well, you got to be in a cage then again.
Can you see me?
All right, go close. Okay, you're in.
What?
Yeah, I got you.
Good one.
I think you're a little too good for that.
Bounce house. Hey.
This is a very cool opportunity for us. Throughout the year, my tigers and I travel with different circuses. We've worked in Big Top and in buildings for the Shriners. But for a couple of months, we get to sit here and relax in beautiful Baraboo and share with you guys more of a behind-the-scenes look as to how we train our animals, why we train them, how we're able to not only develop some cool behaviors for our show, but we can take care of our boys and girls and be able to build a relationship with them that doesn't require a fence in between us. He and his brother Zeus are pushing the food bill through the roof. We're feeding upwards of 70 to 80 pounds of raw meat a day for all of our tigers together. They get a diet of beef, chicken, organ meat. They get a vitamin supplement. They get fish oil. Everything we need to have a healthy and balanced diet. That's a good boy. Everybody give him a round of applause. He's so pretty. Good boy. And we can touch them just as lightly as we can with our finger, but because we're using all of their senses, it makes it very easy for them to understand what it is that we're asking. Because just like our pets at home, our tigers don't speak English. They only know the words that we teach them. Now our two boys are brothers. They were born in the same litter. Zeus's white coloration, just like Jasmine's, is caused by a recessive trait. It's the same genetic process that causes people to have blue eyes. If both parents are carriers of that trait, then they have the possibility of producing that in their offspring, even if they don't exhibit it themselves. Sit down, please. White tigers are not a different... Hey, sit down, please. Good girl. White tigers are not a different species. They're not from a different country. They are the product of a naturally occurring genetic mutation that first occurred in the wild in India. They've all developed different relationships. Some of them are best of friends. Some of them tolerate each other best while we're working, because that's what they're asked to do. This is why you'll see them living together in different groups during the day, so we can ensure everyone is comfortable, and we can avoid conflict. We have a lot of different factors to take into account. There are different personalities, there are different relationships, different distractions, the weather. We have to take these all into account so we can work together safely and smoothly and put together a nice finished product for our presentation.
Thank you. We have three cats. Just that spicy.
Yeah, and we have three different, like, the personalities of our
cats. This is just so cool, because this is, you know, what that movie, Greatest Showman, you know what I mean? Yes. So cool.
People nowadays are taken away from what it used to be.
Oh, I know. Looking at the skyline downtown, you must agree it's a beautiful place. Mm-hmm. Watch your step.
What?
Watch your step. Actually, it doesn't look very scary. It's like a cute little tiger. Iron Tongue Man. Tattooed girl. Alive! Not sure what that is. Oh, cool. That's awesome. Oh, that's cool.
Yeah.
Wow. Oh, sorry.
Novelty instruments.
Huh?
Novelty instruments.
Nice. Cute tigers. Oh, not real, but I mean, they're real stuffed animals, not like they're a figment of my imagination, but I'm just saying. Oh, this is weird. I'm upside down. What the? What's going on?
The most tattooed lady in all of the world, Nora Hildebrandt, the Human Art Gallery. 147 pictures and colorful designs completely cover the body of this fascinating lady from all of the swords. We next call your attention to the world-famous naked enchantress, Amy Arlington. She exhibited anacondas, boa constrictors, rods,
and Regal Python.
What time is this
stuff? 3:15.
Is it 3:15?
Nope. It's 3:06, 3:07. Going to the Big Top Show.
Oh,
All right, how are you? Good.
Are you filming an episode of Live PD?
No, actually not.
Okay.
No, not today. Yeah, sorry, not today.
Are you making a vlog or a vlog?
Yes.
Okay. Hi, my name is Steve Copeland. Nice to meet you.
Nice meeting you.
Let me give you my best side.
All right. Yeah, it is better.
All right, thank you. Have you guys been to Circus World before?
No.
Okay, well.
Years and years and years ago.
Yeah, that's okay. True. When I was about, like, yeah.
Okay. Well, it's much better now because me and Ryan are here.
Excellent.
And any clowns before us tremble before our mighty presence. So, this is our big top. Our show's at 3:15. You guys can sit anywhere you want. I would recommend grabbing some of these box seats. It will be up close and personal.
Awesome.
So, yeah. Enjoy
all right.
The show.
Thank you. Thank you. Oh. Nice. Oh, almost. What? A six? Oh, my lord. Here we go. Yeah! Ha ha ha. Side of it.